Okay, so got an old battery drill, very old, old Ryobi. I've undone the screws out of it, they're sitting there, and take the cover off. And what I've done is I've actually taken off the battery clip, which is this, removed the battery clip. Tried soldering onto it before, but it didn't work, so I thought I'd pull it apart. And what I'm going to do is use the motor gearbox all inside its housing. I'm going to cut the housing off at about here, across the switch, remove the switch, which I can do now, and that's the gear changer there. We don't need that because it doesn't operate a gearbox section, it only operates the electronic forward and reverse, okay? Which is good because we've got electronic forward and reverse on that switch. So it's a variable speed switch. Positive and negative in, got to make sure you get positive and negative right, otherwise you'll blow it up. And positive and negative out. I'm just going to cut those wires. I'm going to solder an extension wire on. Then I'm going to put the housing back together. I'll probably bring the wires out the back of the unit. I don't know. We'll see how we go. So what I'm going to do is cut these cables, solder them, and then we'll have a separate switch from the motor and gearbox. And what we'll do is we'll put a shaft on a wheel, lock the chuck onto the wheel. for an hour. Oops, running backwards. That's alright. Just change the switch forwards. And there we have a bike that's running forwards. Now I'll just modify this a little bit. Tighten that chuck up. Maybe I need something to tighten it up with. I know that I'm probably well and truly over time by now, but actually no, I don't think I am. There we go. Wheel spin and everything. One wheel drive. Let's see how she travels. Brilliant.